Wasn't that Mrs. Monrell?
Yes, that's her.
Beautiful, beautiful.
Between you and me, the manager will be glad to get rid of her. They're hanging her gentleman friend tomorrow morning. 3 o'clock sharp.
Too bad you can't watch it all. You'd enjoy it, wouldn't you? Animals.
Come in. I have nothing to say. Whatever you want to know, you can find it in the newspapers.
2 years ago, this man escaped from a private asylum near Paris. He was suffering from a form of insanity, which we call paranoia. At that time, your husband masqueraded under the name of Ward Andrews.
But who are you? How do you know all this?
I'm the old fool who let him escape. My name is Dr. Rameau. Enchanté.
But, Doctor, this is terribly important. Why didn't you come here weeks ago?
I discovered it only yesterday. May I sit down?
Of course, please.
My old bones dislike your English climate intensely. While I was in Edinburgh listening to some ignorant rubbish at the so-called medical congress, I happened to pick up this paper. What stupidity. What self-contradiction. You were the only intelligent witness. You at least suspected that your late husband was insane.
They wouldn't listen to me because of my friendship with Mr. Andrews.
Come on, sit down. Do you believe that Mr. Andrews killed your husband?
Doctor, I'm certain he didn't. But the evidence...
Evidence, evidence. I spit on evidence. My dear child, forget all that circumstantial rubbish. These knives, these broken vases, these footprints, they are too convenient, too perfect. Look into the human heart and you'll find the motive for this crime.
But if Ward didn't, then who?
Phillip was murdered by his only enemy, himself. Everything you told the jury supports my diagnosis. He hides from the world in the tree of his childhood. He creates a neurotic jealousy and nourishes it like a plant. He tries to destroy everything which he imagines could come between you and him. First the poor little animal, then his best friend. At last, he tries to kill you and himself. And don't you see? Now, with one stroke, he almost succeeded. A classic case. Wonderful.
But how did he do it? And how can we ever prove?
We need prove nothing. Phillip will prove it for us. That sounds insane, but let me tell you, some of my crazy patients are wiser than all your judges and jurymen. Now listen carefully. This disease takes many forms, but one symptom is common to all its sufferers. Their poor sick brains want to show off, to tell the world I'm cleverer than you. They long for recognition, but every normal road to this bar, so they turn to crime. But the crime itself means nothing unless it is talked about. These people, when they commit suicide, leave lengthy statements. When they murder, they love to confess. Your husband will want to speak to you from beyond the grave. His triumph will not be final until you know the truth. Madame, I stake my reputation upon it. A message exists. But... can we find it before it's too late?
We must find it. Come, Doctor. Nothing. Nothing at all.